folks, and welcome back to the channel. It's Nona Rhodes back once again with another video. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe, hit that thumbs up as well as that notification bell. Be much appreciated, folks, as always. So we're here to discuss Michael Keaton. Now, it's been reported by The Wrap that he's in official talks with Warner Brothers to reprise his role as Batman in the DC Extended Universe. You know, as fans, we can always deliberate on who gave the best performance or iteration of the Caped Crusader, but one thing's for sure is we'll always revert back to Tim Burton's 1989 Batman for two main reasons. Number one, it was the first feature film of Batman, and number two, you know what? Michael Keaton really did define that role, because after all,
I'm Batman.
Albeit, there could be slight nostalgia there, because let's not forget, Ben Affleck gave the best fight sequence in Batman vs Superman, and Christian Bale's Dark Knight was just seminal. Moving back to the main topic of this video, it's been reported that the contract will allow for Keaton to appear in many forthcoming DCEU movies. This contract is somewhat commensurate to Marvel Nick Fury, in which he appears in many movies and kind of holds the narrative together. Now, I understand that Michael Keaton's character will be well woven in these forthcoming movies, and the first rodeo under this new contractual agreement will be The Flash, the solo movie. So, this movie will revolve around the infamous Flashpoint event from the comic books, and has also been an animated adaptation of the comic, whereby Barry Allen races into the past to save his mum, and in doing so, he creates a catastrophic sequence of events and creates an alternate universe. As I'm sure you all know, in this universe, Bruce Wayne dies as a child, and his father, Thomas Wayne, takes up the mantle as the Caped Crusader. Now, in this universe, child, there's no Justice League, Wonder Woman is busy fighting the Atlanteans, it's just a hot mess. So, what I can discern from this whole story is once the Flashpoint has been corrected, Bruce Wayne will simply emerge as the older Bruce Wayne, as Tim Burton's Bruce Wayne, and it's as if the franchises are being amalgamated. Guys, please comment below, what are your thoughts of Michael Keaton returning as Batman, as the older version of Batman? Please comment below. In addition to this, then you have Michael Keaton's character Vulture in the Spider-Man movie, as well as his forthcoming appearance in Morbius. So this is a very busy actor. So guys, tell me, do you think Michael Keaton's return as Batman is a good idea? And are you here for this multi-universe concept? To be honest, I am. I'm here for it. I'm loving the way the DCEU is evolving. I'm loving the different alternate universes. So I'm here for it, guys. But please comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And don't forget, guys, in addition to Robert Pattinson's Batman movie, there's been a lot of buzz and speculation about Batman Beyond. So there's lots going on in the DC universe. So I just want to hear from you guys. Do you think that this move by Michael Keaton is a good idea? Do you think it will work? I'd love to hear your comments. Please comment below, and I'll see you down in the comment section. Anyway, guys, take care for now. Bye.